Actually started grabbing rail about halfway down the face and doing a slow, long bottom turn, trying to brush off some speed. And I was thinking, oh, did I dork this? And yeah, I didn't think, for a second, I didn't think it was going to barrel, and then it started finally pitching out. But for a second, I thought I was going to look really silly trying to grab rail mid-face and no barrel. But I was hoping I could get out of it and get a hit, but it was just too quick. And then I had that other barrel. I thought I was going to make it out of that other barrel quicker and be able to hit it, but same thing. It just kind of grabbed me and pushed me down to the bottom. I think it's probably the biggest wave I ever caught in Huntington. So that was fun. And my last one was, it was just a nice clean one. It wasn't a real big one. It was just a nice nice steep one. Let me get a few hits in. And, you know, those are the ones you really look for in a heat so you can surf on them. The other ones, the big ones are kind of, it's a coin toss really whether you're going to make a wave like that or not. It's, you know, most of them close out pretty quickly. And I've seen guys get 10s before in the first wave of heat and lose. I've seen it a lot of times. So, you know, you can't just sit there and go, I got a 10, I'm feeling good. You know, you know, because your next wave can be a 6. You divide that by 2, that's 2/8. So the other guy just has to get 2/8 and catch it. So, you know, it doesn't put it out of range. And the only thing that puts anything out of range is 2 10s, and that, you know, never happens. So it just depends on the surf, really. I mean, you gotta adjust to what the surf does. I mean, if the wind comes up out of the south, or the swell drops, or it's more peaks, or it's more closeouts, you know, you really have to, decide how you're gonna surf the heat. I'd imagine tomorrow will be a little smaller, probably a few more peaks and open face waves, so it'll be more surfing the face than looking for barrels. It's happened 2 heats in a row now. I had a broken board yesterday, and then I had the broken leash today. Luckily, I got to my board before it went into the pilings. But yeah, that kind of gets you focused when that happens, because you got to keep your mind on something. You don't let your mind wander. No, I think everyone, all surfers have a sense like, oh, we know that next one's gonna peak up right here and, you know, be better or whatever. You have a sense of that.